Around the 16th century, Arctic or polar exploration has become well known and practiced. The number of polar expeditions that have taken place in the many centuries to come have continuously added up to the knowledge of the Arctic, including the discovery of new islands. The first recorded exploration was for the westerly passage of the Orient from Europe by Christopher Columbus. What proved to be the hardest expedition was that of the passage through the Arctic islands of Canada. It was eventually established that it was not possible for vessels to use the Hudson Strait to effect a northwest passage, and so a passage further north through Lancaster Sound became the only way for ships of that era to attempt the passage. Over the years, many explorers and even scientists have traveled to the North Pole just for the thrill of it, or for scientific discoveries. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent, and there's a lot to see and a lot to be discovered. One of the many wonderful discoveries of the Antarctic was the notorious Drake Passage. It is located between Cape Horn and the tip of the Antarctic Peninsula, and it is known to have some of the world's most dangerous and roughest waters. Nowadays, with a lot more technology, expeditions through the Antarctic have become a lot easier compared to the dangerous polar expeditions of the 1800s, for instance. During the Romantic era, polar expedition has become important and a goal to many explorers of the age, as it was their life's ambition to leave behind a legacy where they are the ones to travel to the North Pole and find a way through the Northeast Passage, which was not discovered until 1823. This was about the same time as Mary Shelley wrote Frankenstein, and since polar expeditions were very important in this time period, she created a character, Robert Walton, whose desire was to reach the North Pole.